even on a rainy day, man.
Hey, how you doing? I hope you're doing well. Thanks for tuning in. Welcome back to the channel. Jimmy making it work if you're new here. You probably saw that in the bottom of the video, didn't you? We're gonna spend a day in the shop, a gloomy, rainy, wet day, installing engines and all kinds of things. The repairs you might see today are varied and unique. Could be anything from exotics, classics, Asian, domestic, could be trucks, engine installations, light bulbs and wipers. Could be almost anything. Joe's doing an EcoBoost engine. I got a Volkswagen engine just came in to do. But I don't know if we'll start on that today. We'll see. I'll put some clips in right here of what's going to happen in this video. Now you can see we got a pretty gloomy day, but the sun's supposed to come out by 10 or 11 o'clock, so it'll be a little nice later. We'll go from cloudy and overcast to lens flare. Special effects and stuff, no extra charge. Just like subscriptions and twerking the like button, all that stuff's no extra charge. This week only, so act fast. We try to learn a thing or two here. We always have a little bit of fun. Let's get the shop open and get started. Stay tuned. It's Farfik Nugent time. Look, I'm putting the engine in this monstrosity. Apparently it goes out the bottom. And mosquitoes and gnats, that's the new trend. This is the one, if you don't remember, from about, I guess it was about a month now, 3 or 4 weeks anyway, 3 weeks maybe. Starter's bad, but it's only bad because the customer cranked it to death and killed the starter. If you try to turn the engine, it takes about 10 times the force it normally should take pulling the breaker bar, so it'll roll, but barely. In any event, the extended warranty company he has declined the repair, so we're doing it. It's like $9,000 to put an engine in one of these, by the way. Used engine's like $5,500, 60-day warranty. Let's get started. First thing we gotta do is get this battery out of here and the air box. Then we'll see what's going on. Huh. We haven't even started yet, and I pulled the surrounder dealio off the battery to get to that 13. You can't see it with the heat wrap on it. But I'm noticing a trend. Tie wrap. Basically everything's broken and we haven't started yet. Hey, we're gonna do the best we can do. Don't you worry about it. Well, this is taped together, so I'm gonna have to do the old twist-a-rooney and see if we can, oh, the heck? Oh, okay, it pushes down on this. Not supposed to come off with it, I guess. It's not supposed to stay on the post, it's supposed to stay in there. No, I guess this is the inlet, so that would be still filtering the air. That's good. Three of those, the battery tray should be out of here. We got a broken air filter dealio too. Maybe we'll have to try out the plastic loader tool for that when we go back to get it. Now I can see the transmission. I take these wheels off so we can get the axles out. And it says to take the wheel liners out too. I'm not sure why. Probably something in there cool that you want to get loose first. Got wheel locks like I thought.
Gotta find that thing.
If you forget the wheel lock and it's in the trunk, you gotta put the battery back in to get it open. FYI. If you don't know, now you know.
Look at that.
Hey, Jimmy.
You.
The
old
man?
Yep. Oh, you're welcome. Gravity check. Axle's got to come out of here somehow. And rather than bolt these stupid studless wheels back on, I'll make the sacrificial vessel screwdriver. Look at that thing. Right in that brake rotor fin. These things are usually pretty tight too. What's the big deal? Tecton half inch ratchet. Old school Craftsman 15/16 12 point, and the vessel screwdriver. No damage. Maybe tweak just a little bit so it's not completely straight anymore, but it's pretty. That's my imagination. Straight as an arrow, never mind. The next thing's gonna be to get coolant out of this thing, and I'll drain the oil as well. But Gotta get the old Icon flush cutters first, because everything's tie wrapped together apparently. The push pins aren't that expensive, but not as cheap as tie wraps, I suppose. This one's just, this is the fixed broken part. Because, Farfig Nugent. Car's 10 years old, so what do you expect? Oh, I see what happened. The little blind nuts are missing. So they put tie wraps in. I thought it was push pins missing. It's a bunch of Torx wood screws. 25s. Get some of those out of there, we'll be able to drain the coolant. Next thing's gonna be getting these wheel liners out the way. I'd probably try to work around them if they were push pins and stuff, but they're all wood screws, so it wouldn't be too bad, right? Now I can see some stuff, and you can see where people have been working on this already. Might be this car's third engine, because, Volkswagen, one of the most popular cars in the world. I don't know if it shows up on camera, but someone has been in a suspension. Well, it's got red struts. I don't know what that means, but the oil pan's been off, the bell housing bolts, the motor mount bolts. Someone's already done some work. The ball joints have been taken off. Anytime you see the nut looks like that, it's had sockets and impacts on it and stuff. So, in any event, like I said, it might be on his third engine. I don't know. I also know Volkswagen decided you don't need a drain in the radiator. So, maybe I'm missing it. You guys see one? Let's at least get the oil out of it so we feel like we get some progress going. I think it's like T47 carbine. See how new the oil looks? I'm guessing it was run out of oil and then they put oil in it when it shut off. That happens pretty regular. They're like, oh, I haven't checked the oil or changed it in 2 years. I had a motor stop running, I'm gonna put oil in it. It's not really funny. I'm gonna get some of these turbo ducts out of the way so I can see more stuff. I think this is aftermarket. ECS tuning. It's so easy to sell people stuff. Whatever makes you happy, man. I watched Rain Man Ray put a hot air intake on a Tahoe. That was pretty funny. Especially because he called it a hot air intake. That's mine. I got rights. Ray needs to pay up. I doubt I was the first one to say it. Just like if I started calling my wife wife unit. You wasn't the first one. I'm not gonna do that though. That's off. Grab it, check, pry bar. I don't have to take the belt off before we remove any engine, but you don't have to worry about it rocking on a stand or anything while you do it. The next thing is to pull some of these lower bell housing bolts out, so when the engine's sitting on the ground or stands or whatever, I end up putting it on. I don't have to try to get to the bottom tranny bolts to separate them. The way this one works, pull the engine and trannies out the bottom together and separate them out. The wrench ratchets and the bolt mount finger tires just barely able to get it by old man hands. This is gonna be one of those applications that the bolts are like 7 different lengths, so you gotta be really careful putting them back. Sometimes they're all the same. Most of these, when you put them in, they'll probably be about this much sticking out of the bell housing or so, so you know you got it in the right location. obviously, if that much is sticking out, it's too long. And if it bottoms out, it's too short, right? I try to keep them in order, but I'm using the lift to hold them, so. Might as well get these lower ball joints unbolted. You gotta pull the drive shafts out. Axles, whatever you like to call them. Some people call them half shafts. I got the breaker bar and the 12 point on the axle bolt. And I got my long reach ratchet and my triple square on the axle bolts. And you gotta loosen them all this way because my 3/8 ratchet just spun the axle, so kinda sucks, but I had to tighten the axle back up a little bit, but nothing like it was before. I didn't want to use an impact release because it's chromey. Chrome sockets will work on an impact, but it really messes up your impact gun. Ball detent and ring detent sockets are different. Not to mention the materials. That's all six of them. Gotta do the other axle, of course, but it'd be silly to film both sides, right? Come on, where you at? Usually they're pretty, the axle and the hub is pretty short, the spline portion. And if they pop right out, but doesn't seem to do that. Where it's at. It kind of binds up on the tub, so I can't pull out. Cool. I'll struggle with this a minute, and we'll come back after victory. All right. Now, the axle splines are like an inch and a half. That doesn't mean anything. If I lowered it down, it'd probably be easier. I'm not doing that. Still got work to do up top. I mean, underneath. Still got work to do underneath. Goodness gracious. I win. Second axle's out. Quick trip to the parts department. Headed to the exhaust shop, jeez. Jeez Louise. I don't know what Louise had to do with it, but she's been involved in some way, I'm sure. It's perfectly normal. Nothing to see here.
See alligators jumping out the window.
Oh, God, help us.
Rowdy Downy!
Woo!
Alright. I can never find a place to drain the coolant. It's as if Volkswagen thinks these will never need to be worked on. I don't know. Put some big drain pans underneath and just start pulling hoses off and let nature take its course, or antifreeze at least.
Rowdy
Gowdy. Coolant tank's gotta come out. Held it with a couple of wood screws. Popped a little spring slide out of there. That's what locks the hose in place, and popped it right off. I'm gonna take all that out of the way. They tell you to take the radiator out. I don't know why. I don't think you need to, so I'm not gonna. Maybe the fans might be in the way a little, but the compressor's gonna be off. Probably hang that out of the way, and then this is going to barely clear. This is going to barely clear. The transmission is over the subframe just a little, so it'll have to tilt a little this way when it goes down, but there's plenty of room over there. So, we'll see what happens. You know the deal. Mechanics like to live on the edge, sort of saying.
If you're not familiar with these modern marvels, the European brand started it. And there's a lot of domestics that do it too now. Because they were like, whoa, that is a cool idea. I don't know why they said it, but I don't really agree. It's great for assembly though when they're new. And everything's nice and goes together easy. If you don't get this click back on just right, when you push it back together, you'll hear a click. But if that spring's not completely in, they can pop off when it gets hot. So you really got to pay attention to that, be patient with it, and give it a tug after you put it together to make sure it's not going to come apart on its own. You got to gently pry on the outside where the hose is and not pry on the radiator and cause a problem. The O-ring sticks to the plastic after it's been there for 9 or 10 years, or in the case of a Volkswagen, 6-8 months. I'm going to take these fans out of here because it's not hard. One electrical connector on the bottom, four little torquey screws. Of course, with that out of the way, you got to be even more careful that nothing smashes into the radiator. We don't want any of that business. There's some hookers down there to hold on to this. Hooks, whatever you want to call it. Try turning this way. Next thing is the wiring harness. I don't see a main connector for leaving it on the engine, so I think I gotta take all the harness connectors off and pull the whole harness off to the side. It's just less to do once it's out, I guess. I don't know. I know it has to happen one way or another. You're gonna get the new engine didn't come with a harness, so whatever. I'll just take them all off. Some of these are push pins, clips. Some of them, this bracket comes out. All these little lock pins. You can lift the plastic case with the harness. And of course, coils. Looks like cam sensor. Stuff like that. Shouldn't be too bad. Throttle body and stuff I already got. I thought that was a connector down there, but it's a ground. So. Alright, now we're getting somewhere. I think. Therefore, I am. Oh, there's another one down there. These sons of guns. Here I am, flipping the camera on, thinking we're getting somewhere, and there's more stuff. Little flip missing. I couldn't get it off, so I stuck this down in there, got it to pull off. But now it's not going to stay on, so that might be a problem. We'll see.
These are single-use connectors, I guess. Come on now.
All right, we got one more.
That one's not so bad. That was a multi-use connector. It's got a tab you can push down there. The other ones have it kind of blocked off, and you got to jam something in there to get to the relief. I can't explain it. I'm guessing it's still just a way to get back. All right, enough of the silliness. Oh, there's another one. Oh, two more.
Can't see it from here.
That's terrible. Where's that go? Can I feel it? Nope. Okay.
If I could undo the wiring from the alternator, I might as well just pull the alternator out anyway. It's got to get transferred over.
Watch that radiator.
Get one of those top bolts last.
Alright. This one has Destructo connector on it, and you can't get to it, so let's see what we can come up with. There you go. It's easy, man. What's the big deal? How many times I have to say that, complain about it, and then it comes right out. Teach me a lesson. Uh-oh. Should have said the words, it comes right out all together like that. Should have broke them up somehow. A couple Torx bits. I think it's rubber hoses on the other end. I'll be able to pull that hose. This is all molded plastic, by the way. Even the bracket is molded to the plastic tube. What could go wrong? Now, this should give me some room. Doesn't get much easier. All right. That wiring harness is what I was going for. I'm not sure if it fits out from under the electronic water pump and thermostat assembly or not. But I'm probably going to transfer it over anyway. Might as well take it off. I'll just have a... I got piles of parts under this car everywhere. So, a little four-cylinder. You know, back in the day, it was vacuum hoses. Now it's intricate wiring harnesses and stuff, but it's just different. It's the same but different. I'm going to go ahead and pull the refrigerant out so I can just take the compressor out of my way. I think that's why they want you to take the radiator out, so you can hang the compressor there without risking damaging it. So to me, it's just, I'll just pull the refrigerant out and take the compressor completely out. If you look at the way they designed it, which I'm not going to say it's the engineer's fault for this, but the there's a pressure hose that goes to the condenser from the compressor, and it goes under the compressor, and then the suction hose comes back from the evaporator to the top of the compressor as well, but one's at the top, one's at the bottom. So you can't completely pull the compressor up, you can't completely let it down, so it's going to kind of be in the way. So I got to unbolt it from the engine anyway. If I pull the refrigerant out, I can pull the two hoses off and just get it completely out and not have to worry about it. Won't damage your radiator or anything. It's a T45. I'm going to take the one line off, leave the other one on, and that way I can lift it out, kind of put it over here on the fender out of my way. Because all I got to really mess with up here now is going to be the mounts. And this thing goes out the bottom. I got to do the exhaust too. I have to mess with that first, but that'll be the last thing I'll do is the exhaust. Two mounts, it's out. AC compressor and my hose capped off. Just for safekeeping. I'm going to put a rag here between the fender and the compressor just in case. Oh, see that? Still refrigerant air popped it out. That's pretty funny. Gotta get that wiring harness out. I had to undo this little auxiliary water pump, I guess that is. Just one bracket. And then a tab keeps them turning. A couple of hoses. And I gotta transfer all this stuff anyway, so just get it out of there. Try not to get coolant everywhere. Try to get most of it out. Now I think the wiring harness is free from everything except the transmission. Starter cable and starter wire and transmission connector. Now, there's nothing holding this in electrically. Exhaust and motor mount bolts. Undid these two bolts, undid the clamp that ties the converter into the turbo, moved it back enough so that the subframe is in front of it when it comes to getting it out. It won't be trying to hit the exhaust. I left all this on. Comes with a really handy dandy little strap clamp, so I just slid it all back out of my way, pulled it out of that. These clamps make it a lot easier to work on exhaust pipes, so we are really getting close now. I gotta come up with some kind of apparatus to hold this in place, lower it down, and be able to take the transmission and engine and separate them without everything falling on the ground. Let's see what we can come up with. Now I gotta set my hodgepodge of jack stands at varying locations at various heights, and I mostly wanna hold up the motor and balance the transmission, because the motor's gonna come off. once we get it all out of the car. So I'm gonna adjust some of these bad Johnnies to get the exact heights I need so things aren't so tippy. Oh, you know what? I gotta get the heater hoses real quick first. I just realized that. All right, that's better. Disconnecting them from the engine side just because I think it's less fragile than the heater core side and probably slightly easier to get to. I don't know. 318s and 218s. Oh, I got one more hose. Dang it, man. They keep popping up everywhere. I should stop looking. I guess that would be destructive though. That's the hard part. Now, there's probably only a couple things left I haven't seen yet. We'll find out. Gotta get a floor jack, raise the timing belt, or timing chain, whatever side, about one tooth on my jack stand to get them all level. Subframe is going to hit the transmission in the back by about that much. See me? I'm gonna go ahead and discombobulate that and we'll continue. Well, I know why they want you to take the radiator out. Let me tell you what. That's a little too close for comfort. I think we're mostly out, so it shouldn't have to be bounced around anymore, but the way this thing is, the parts of the turbo hit the subframe over here, parts of the transmission hit the subframe over there, so you kind of have to roll it forward as you bring it out. And that brings us really close to the radiator. So probably what I'll do is after I get this out, I think I'll take the radiator out before I put it back together. Because I don't want to risk it twice. Came close enough once.
There's just a little schmidgy. Huh. Gravity check! I'm guessing someone's got a problem with oil burning in their Cadillac Escalade. And I'm guessing someone's got a problem with the engine falling off the jacks and breaking the wastegate dealio. I doubt they're available separately, so it's probably going to need a turbo. Probably a good idea to put a turbo on an engine after it blows up anyway. Yep, turbo's no good anyway.
see that play in the impeller? It's not much, but any is no good. So I don't feel quite as bad because it needs a turbo anyway. Anytime I do one of these engines, I would recommend a turbo, but I'm not sure how that all went. I got to look at the paperwork and see. But there's no doubt about it now. So Volkswagen, Audi, same difference.
He wants to borrow a C-clamp so we can put a clip in for it.
You can do
what? I want to know if you had a C-clamp she could borrow.
What? Did she say or she didn't know?
She wanted to borrow a C-clamp. Help her put a clip in real quick. She didn't want to pay. She didn't want to pay us to do it. She just wanted to borrow a tool to do it herself. But she didn't seem very mechanically inclined.
Driving even an older one like that,
that thing's still probably 30 grand. Let's hope this will fit in there to get that little bracket for the turbo line off. The turbo cooler line. Of course the bracket bolts tucked up in here. Can't fit a regular bit in there, so good thing that fit. We're down two people today, so you might hear the phone ring a little more. I've got to commend Hans and Franz on some brilliant ideas on ways to get this kind of stuff done. We're getting there. All right, I got about 45 minutes into trying to get the lines off of here. And they're in there pretty good. So congratulations to Volkswagen on a job well done. Hans and Franz, you guys are killing it over there. Not sure what else is hooked to it. Oh, there's another. Oh, that's what that other line was. Okay, just. There's three or four lines going to this turbo. I cut my, opened my wound again. That's all right. I saw blood in the antifreeze. I'm like, what the heck is going on? No. This is, it's exciting. It's really exciting to put an engine in a Volkswagen. Oh, there it is. I'm trying to find this. I had to make a special contraption to fit underneath some of the other brackets for the other line. It goes into my 12 millimeter gear wrench socket.
Some more bolts coming out.
Okay.
I hope I remember where all these bolts go. It's a lot of them. These are the bolts for the turbo. So
we'll get it.
We will get it.
Let's see if it'll come out.
All these lines were like rusted into the block too. Very strange. I've done Chrysler, Ford, GM. Never had lines frozen in the block like these. Maybe this car was up north or something. I don't see. Yeah, it's not rusty. The only rust is around the block. I wonder if this engine came out of a car from up north. That's possible. A long time ago, because someone's been in this engine multiple times probably. I see silicone everywhere. It's not factory. Anyway, get one more line and this is out. Turbo's on the way. I can't explain it. I tried my best. It's carry on. I'm not sure if that's going to be reusable, but we'll try. I could not get it out of the block for anything, so I had to hammer a screwdriver and then hammer a screwdriver and hammer. I kept going under and over the fitting until I got it to force it out of the block. So I don't know, maybe they're pressed in by a robot or something. I'm not sure. I took the bolt out of there because I want to take this line over to the vise and straighten out that flange so I can get the bolt through it and all. But once you do that, you got to get the shield out of the way. And to get the shield out of the way, there's a triple square over here This was a Torx, and this one's an Allen. You can't make this stuff up. I just keep taking stuff off. See how this is frozen in here? The other line I put on a vise. Put it in a vise, hammer to punch through so I'd be able to get the bolt in. And the flange is a little tweaked, but that'll be all right. When I tighten it up, this will hit the block and the bolt will flatten it out. It'll be fine. So it might even come with the turbo. I'm not sure yet, but I wanted to prepare it in case it doesn't. I've never seen anything like it. I mean, I shouldn't say I've never seen anything like it. I should say something more along the lines of, I haven't seen something like this in a while. I've seen basically everything there is to see almost. Except for a Tesla that burns oil. I haven't seen that. It was a Suburban burning oil today, but not a Tesla. If I can remember how to get this together, I'm going to be really proud of myself. Another triple square for that one. I'm not sure if the threads are even different yet, but there's triple squares, Allen heads, and Torx. And I don't remember the combination, but I don't think it'll be that big of a deal. I'm guessing the threads are slightly different. So we will see. I just had a funny thought. We were trying to figure out what motor it has toward the turbo, but the engine's already here. So I hope it's the same. It looks the same. Everything looks exactly the same, to tell you the truth. It's got rust right around where this one has it. Of course, I took the hoses off on the other end, but that's fine. I have to look very carefully to see what they broke. They always break things. Sometimes they break manifolds. You got to change that out. So I think it looks like the right engine, so we'll be good. All that stuff is just turbo related, except for the front bracket I took off. I didn't really have to because it has one on it. I got the old girl resting. Joe's doing this eco boom, and I'm doing an engine job too. It's kind of unusual, both of us doing engines at the same time. Anyway, thanks for watching today's video. A little frustrating day today, to tell you the truth. I really appreciate you watching, hanging in there with me, because that was tough. Almost turned the camera off and just finished the day without filming anything. But I don't want to disappoint you guys. I wanted to have some content for you, even though I'm a little aggravated. I'm going to push on through, row my boat, and get it done. Find a way to make it work. You guys know the deal. If you've been around a while, you know what's going to happen. I'm going to get it done. You might have to take a few minutes here and there as a break. That's all. Twerk the like button on your way out if you would. Subscribe if you haven't yet. And I hope I see you in the next one, because you're awesome.